This is what flashy pastor Tobi Adegboyega, a Nigerian domiciled in the United Kingdom, has to say about his many problems and challenges. Well, some might call it karma. I want you to listen to what he has to say, and afterwards, we'll be talking. Don't forget to like and share. Tap on the subscribe button. He has a lot to say about his deportation.
Hi, good evening, Paul. Let me pause this. I've heard a lot today, and I'm doing this because of our fans, our friends, people who are worried. I'm right here at home, no cause for alarm, and naturally I'll dismiss things that has to do with retrogression. Every Nigerian should be proud of me. Being in the UK, a city that is well known for pulling people down, I've survived all sorts. So the matter that they are propagating now is the smallest of matter. In Yoruba, they say, Toba le ni ni bikoi bikoi on darisi abilusi.
Yeah.
No. Oh, they did leave me. But what I'm trying to say is no panic. I love London City. It's my city and nobody can do anything. Of all the people of color you know here, pastors and leaders, have survived everything. Now, let me talk about fraud case. They keep saying this. This is an advanced country. I'm speaking here openly, yeah? After all these years, have you ever heard someone goes to the parliament and make all sort of complaint? Someone from another race and another color. Nothing came out of it. So those who hate already. What you want to hear is not what you heard today. What you want to hear is they've arrested them for money this, money that. Not one criminal case, not one money case. You should all be proud of me and of the nation family. So I'm here, I'm at home. Nobody should panic for me. I succeeded well in this country despite all challenges. And I'm in the league of the people you look up to, people that they'll pick out to persecute. I've survived that well. We're surviving well. Nothing has changed. Nothing will change. I assure all our followers and friends that there will be no embarrassment for you other than noise and noise, which we've survived for many years. I am here. I'm PT, number one in London City, and nothing is going to bring us down. I love you all. That's all I've got to say for now. Thank you. Anyone, please? PS5. Thank you.
And I'll let you know what the delicacies are this evening. So we'll be having a tomahawk steak. It's a very luxurious cut of the ribeye of the cow, and it's often served with the bone. So the tomahawk is represented as an axe of war, and that is why it's a very luxurious meat. So when you go to the restaurant and you ask for a tomahawk, you know that you're going to get a very, very succulent, very big piece of beef.
What is funny is that even if they deport Pastor Tobi today and is back to Nigeria, he would open a church, a ministry, and the ministry will be successful, because I believe that the God that Nigerians serve is money. There was an article written, you know, some years ago about how to serve the Nigerian God, because the Nigerian God is different from the God of the Bible or the God in the Quran. Even the Pastor Tobi name, I believe, is a nickname. That cannot be a real name, like he's a pastor, you know.
Well, unless something else happens in the next couple of hours, what we know is that Pastor is facing immigration issue. He came into the United Kingdom on a visitor visa 2005, and somehow it seems he has been unable to get himself sorted out. He was seeking for leave to remain, and he was rejected. I don't know if he was able to get himself off from the legal status that he was. I don't know how, or if he did. I don't know if he had to do it through a child, anchor baby, as they call them, or he did it via marriage. I don't know how he went about it. The point is this: the United Kingdom Immigration Home Office refused his appeal. They refused his appeal to remain in the UK. And for them to have gotten to that point, it means they must have looked into certain laws and policy. But he has a right to fight this to finish. He might be taking this to the Supreme Court. The European Union law does not permit you to separate families, and he's a married man with his children and wife. So we will see how all of this will turn out to be. The appeal itself is what has been refused and rejected. So I don't know if he has no other ways of sorting this. Now, someone said if he is to get involved in anything at all, or even if the police stops him and requests for his document and he does not have it to present, they will be taking him to, they'll be calling the immigration and handing him over to the Home Office. Immigration will then, maybe will now seek for, it's a complex situation. That's the point, that like he's in a dire situation. But the thing about every of this, if he is truly rich, because we've seen him give certain people who are in his circle some expensive gift, such as a £20,000 watch and a £500,000 watch, half a million. I mean, this guy can splurge, and we've heard that he has a deep pocket. How did he come about this? Well, one day he felt God called him, Spark Nation, that's what it's called. He said he had this call to regenerate and renew the minds of young people, particularly those from his race, those people who have issues in their homes. He wants to bring them back to God and also make them realize purpose. When they got in, the next thing Mr. Toby did was to encourage them on how to get cash. Like, you guys have to be rich. You guys have to make, you have to make something. You guys have to do something. But of course, you can't tell people to make money if you yourself don't appear like you are rich. So you have to make yourself appear rich. How did he go about it? What did he do? Are there things that he did that eventually gave him some, like, a little bit of step up where he can drive a certain expensive car that he knows that a 20-year-old or 18 or 19 or 20-something in the UK does not have access to? These guys started opening their eyes to certain things that they might not want to normally, like getting loan that you know you have to pay. You are obliged, you are tied to your loan. So he encouraged them to get loan. He encouraged them to seek for money to open a business. Let us register businesses on your name. Let us open this so that you can do all about how to make money. So these guys, when they go loan, he will now encourage them to sow seed. Even told some of them, according to what we heard, to sell their blood. Yes, like literally go donate money for seed. Donate blood for seed. Blood for seed. Like, go sell your blood. If Jesus Christ can die on the cross, go do something. If you don't have any idea, I've given you an idea. So for them, and you know, the UK is a place where competition is. So he had to like press some of them, and became like, and he knows what to do to keep these guys together, like where they play online game, like a home, a house where they can all gather to sit and commune and even sleep in. He created this community, a hook. And he has some young girls and guys that is sent out there to go and attract younger people. Like, hey, come eat for free. Come join our community. It's called Spark Nation. And he does his thing on the street with expensive cars. Maybe he has some of them or he rented some of them. Sports car. They go all over the street to create that. We are rich. We are the balling guy. He knows what they want. He knows what young people want. He got those guys, at, you know, hooked to it until we started hearing stories of, how did you make money? How are you this rich? What's going on? What are your thoughts about this issue? Drop your comments.
I say a very big thank you to those who have taken time to subscribe to this channel. And if you're yet to subscribe, kindly tap on that subscription button and also the red bell icon so you will be notified whenever videos such as this are uploaded.